Hi, welcome to the part 10 of this video series. Here we are looking at real certification questions for AWS Solution Architect Associate. Please subscribe to my channel. Please focus on the story of each question and the concepts explained through each option. The key is how to weed out the right options. For questions 1 to 35, please refer parts 1 to 9 of this video series. These are all brand new questions. Please do visit this playlist. This has 14 videos with 100 questions, and these questions are still relevant. If you are preparing for the certification exam, please go through both the series, this one and the old one. Both are relevant. This one is having new questions, and together these will guarantee the surety of passing. Let's jump into the questions. Question 36. Please pause the video, read it carefully. Let us go through the story first. There is a web application and it is constantly receiving stock information through API gateway. Now, if you understand the gist of this question, this is a security question. You should always try to weed out the options, get a crux of the story and understand which topic is this linked to. So we know it is linked to security. So let's go through the options. First one says, see, before we even dig into each and every detail, since it's a security question, I want to provide security. If I see these four options, only WAF provides security. So option B, WAF, would be my answer. If I see options A and D, they both use CloudFront. And what does the thumb rule say? CloudFront is used for caching and improving latency. That means it improves performance of this web application. This is a security question, not a performance question. So A and D are wrong. Let's see option C. It says to use CloudWatch metric count. See, it is used to monitor the logs, and using the logs, it can count the number of events and then it can send the alerts. We have to stop the flooding. This HTTP flooding means DDoS. DDoS attacks. You have to prevent these attacks. So option C is also wrong. So if you see WAF, it prevents applications from common web exploits. This is used to prevent DDoS mitigation. We will lock this answer, move forward. Question 37. So you may pause this video, understand the story. So the story is the key. If you have EC2 instances, and what you have to do is you want to check whether it adheres to the compliance requirements. Compliance is the key here. See, whenever you say must verify and show, see, in real life, who does the verification? A police inspector. So in this set of options, can I spot inspector? Yes. So C is my answer. C, I can see an inspector here. This is my answer. Why? Simply, I showed you common sense. Inspector is meant for that. So if you see this, inspector is meant for automatic vulnerability management service. It's that service and scans the AWS workloads, including EC2 instances, and it will tell you if they are vulnerable or they are having unintended network exposure. So we have our answer, but let's look at other options. See, A, MESI. See, MESI is used to protect your sensitive data at scale. Primarily, it is used with S3. So you put it on S3, it will detect and discover your sensitive data. You see this? It will detect your sensitive data and it will also take action. It will either encrypt it or whatever remediation it has to do, it will do it. So A is wrong. B says to use GuardDuty. See, GuardDuty will take action immediately. It will prevent. But here you want to know, inspect. You want to inspect and see whether it will adhere. So it is a step before that. Before a hack happens or DDoS attack happens, it will inspect first. So that's why GuardDuty is a post occurrence, that action you have to take real time. So GuardDuty is wrong in this scenario. Let's look at last option, event bridge. See, it is an event bus, serverless event bus, and it is used to build event driven applications at scale. Primarily used with real time data. Okay, our business case doesn't have real time scenario. Event bridge is totally out of context. C is our right answer. Let's move forward. Question 38. Please pause the video here, understand the story and focus on the concepts and technique used to weed out the wrong answers. So from the story, it looks like it is a database encryption question. See, there are EC2 instances and RDS database is hosted on these EC2 instances. So the EC2 data is backed up in RDS, and this RDS has to be encrypted. Why it has to be encrypted? Because it stores PII information like your social security number, Aadhaar number, and so on. Example, anything that has to do with your national ID. So in a crux, what is required? You want to encrypt this data set. All the data should be encrypted at rest. There are two types of encryption, at rest and in motion. If the data is residing on RDS and it has to be encrypted, that is at rest. If the data is moving across networks, say from EC2 instances to RDS or some other services, that requires encryption in transit. Let's look at the options and see what has to be done. So I want to encrypt the database RDS encryption. So I want to switch it on RDS encryption. So D is my answer. Stupid, but common sense. Stupid things are mostly more easy to remember. So what D says is it will encrypt the EC2 instance, that is this EC2 instance, as well as it will encrypt the RDS database using KMS to encrypt the instance as well as the database volumes. So this is our answer. But is life so easy? Yes, it is so easy. On this channel, life is very easy. See, scan through the options. Option 1A, whenever you are using thumb rule, remember, whenever you are using certificate manager, that means it is encryption in transit. So for encryption in transit, you should use certificate manager because you will save the certificates, and from there you will use those certificates to encrypt whenever the communication happens across the network. This is a thumb rule. So A is wrong. See, if you want to provide security on the hardware level, then you have to use this because it can easily generate and use its own encryption keys. This is not the purpose of this question. So B is wrong because we just have to encrypt what? The EC2 instances and RDS. We don't want to use hardware encryption and those kind of stuff here. KMS encryption will work. And this option is not even talking about database and EC2 instance encryption. So B is wrong. Let's look at C. See, option C is using the word SSL. SSL always comes with encryption in transit, because it is called secure socket layer. It's a port-to-port communication, secure port communication. It is related to encryption in transit and not for encryption at rest. Your question is talking about encryption at rest. You see, it is just talking about encryption at rest. Here, this line is encrypted at rest. So this is your final answer, option D. Let's look at the other question, question 39. Pause the video here. Understand the story, understand the concept and the technique to weed out the wrong options. So this is a love triangle question. You have one database and there are two processes, just like one girlfriend or one girl and two boys proposing her. So it's like two processes, and what is happening is these processes, both the processes are trying to access the database, and there is a performance issue. When suppose process one is accessing it, process two gets performance issues and so on. It's simple. I'll not go to the detail of the question, but this question falls in the same category. Remember, here you have to select two options. In the exam, you have to be very vigilant. In certain cases, you have to select one option. In certain cases, you have to select multiple options as the answer. See, here, if I see this, for the first thing, apply the thumb rule. Whenever you have to solve this kind of bottleneck issue, the first thing is create a read replica. We saw that in different questions where there is a reporting system, process two is a reporting system, and we create a read replica. So same applies here. So thumb rule, create a read replica of the database to avoid bottlenecks. This is one. Can I see a replica in any options? Yes, I can see only in option C. So that's one of my answers. Okay, I cannot see a replica anywhere else, so I not care. Now, what is the second thumb rule? Create multi-master setup to solve bottleneck issues. What is multi-master? Usually I have one single master and other are read replicas. But in multi-master, we have two masters. Instead of single master, there are multiple masters and both can do read and writes. In single master, writes can only be done by the master. It can read and write both, but the replicas, these are all read replicas. So if this single master fails, the one of these replicas will become the master and also try to write. This is called high availability. But if you see the multi-master configuration, so when you have multi-master configuration, two primary masters, so will this still be called high availability? No, this will not be called high availability. This will be called continuous availability. So this is another solution. We will switch into a multi-master cluster. So we got our two answers. Okay, if you see the other options, like first, migrate the database to serverless. Serverless will only help you reduce the cost. It will not help you solve the performance bottlenecks, because serverless, the main use is if you need the database, it will be up. If you don't need the database, it will be down. Okay, so A is wrong. Let's look at option B. It is saying to increase the instance size. This database is now this big. It is telling it to make it more big. See, if this is a girl and there are two boys trying to propose her, increasing the girl's size will not help you out. The bottleneck will still be there. So option B is wrong. Let's look at last option, option D. See, multi-AC deployment is not a performance solution. It is a solution used for failover. If one AC fails, you will still have the data available. So the use case in this question is very different. So E is wrong. These two are our final answers. Let's look at question number 40. Pause the video here, understand the story and the concepts, and try to weed out the wrong answers. For me, this is a storage question, like S3, ABS, volumes, etc. So what do I need to store? I need to store these past performance reports. So these are the reports. You have to store it. See, the solution should be global solution, okay? It's saying that it should grow to suit company's worldwide website requirements, and it should be cost effective, and it should minimize infrastructure resource provisioning and deliver the quickest reaction feasible. So let me decode the ask first. So it says solution should be cost effective. So if I see these options, S3 is the most cost effective, but I have I just have one S3 option. So A is my answer, but let's look at other words. Minimize infrastructure resource provisioning. Still A is my answer, and then it says deliver the quick reaction time, which means low latency. Like if you are visiting Netflix, you want nothing, you know, no wait time. You just want to access it as soon as possible. So we have a thumb rule: use CloudFront for low latency. So if you see option A has CloudFront and S3, this is our answer. Okay. So let's look at other options: Lambda and DynamoDB. So nobody stores a document. If you see these last year performance reports, these might be some files, documents, PDFs, or so on. Nobody stores them in DynamoDB. DynamoDB is a NoSQL database. Okay, it provides very low latency, single digit millisecond performance for a database, NoSQL database. We don't require a database for this use case. So B is wrong. We use DynamoDB in applications like Uber, Lyft, which requires millisecond performance for its user base. Nobody stores a document in EC2. EC2 is the costliest option compared to S3. We want a cost effective option. So S3 is more cost effective than EC2. And the last option, option D, this is used for routing. This is not used for performance of the reports and storage. This is not even a storage. So D is totally out of context. So this is our answer. We lock our answer, and this brings us toward the end of this part. Please subscribe to my channel. Please go through this video series on AWS Solution Architect. This is relevant. Together, this series with this latest one will help you with surety of passing. Like I always say, focus on the concepts. For questions 1 to 35, please refer parts 1 to 9 of this video series. This brings us to the end of part 10. See you in the next part.